Zelda. You want to go? I'm gonna get my little parent in there. He can play. Zelda wants to play, but give me a minute. What was that? Hold on, bro. What you say? I told you to play when I get done. I'm trying to jump.
Hold up. Hey, what's going on out here? Hey, get out of my pocket. Hold up. Hey, what's going on out here? I'm trying to stop you from getting on you, bro.
Don't say that about my mom.
You need to head up out of here, bro. Right, head up out of here if I let him go, bro. Yeah. That man up in here fighting. Come up in here. That boy, we can't get ahead. The folk want to come up in here and fight. And y'all ain't got nothing to say. I don't want to hear nothing of none of y'all. The both of y'all out of line. Both of y'all out of line and he out of line. But guess what? We're going to show them today. On my show, ain't going to be no fight. Y'all shut up.
Yeah. We back again. We got on Adrian in the building. He already slick swole up.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That man from MI. Cricket letter, cricket letter. But see, that ain't the only thing cricket. Cause he still owe me $50. When that day I trained his clients. Oh, wow. See, he ain't gonna call me about that. Tell me about that. But he gonna spend all his money on stuff to get that afro as perfect as it is. Who you think he is? But tell me a little bit about Mississippi, how you came up, things of that nature. I wanna hear about that right now.
Don't really have a lot of memories of Mississippi because, you know, my mom got me out of there as quick as possible.
Okay.
You know, not a lot of opportunities out there. But, you know, I visit every now and then.
Okay.
I'm from the Delta, Greenville, Mississippi.
Delta, Greenville. Mm-hmm. Okay. Shout out to Delta, Greenville. Okay. So, tell me a little bit about what happened after you left Mississippi. Because you ain't tell me much who I got in here. Mario.
What the hell?
You can sit there and throw Mario all you want to. You can throw Mario all you want to. That was my partner and it was about to beat you up earlier.
Oh, okay. Oh, man. Okay.
They were about to drill you up earlier.
Oh, okay.
They were on your head. If I ain't grabbed no boys, it was going to be a wrap.
I see. Okay.
Anyway, I hear you from old College Park. So that's where you came when you left Mississippi. Let me hear about that. I want to hear about that, how you grew up out there. You know what I'm saying? First of all, go ahead and tell us who you are. You know what I'm saying? Go to say your name, your full name. I want to hear the whole thing.
My name is Adrian Jones. I'm the regional marketing director at Pinstrikes Entertainment Center, one of the best bowling alley and entertainment centers in the city.
Okay.
So be sure to check us out.
Okay, go ahead and say where we can find you at. You talking about check y'all out. Where can we find you?
We're in Stockbridge, 3478 Mount Zion Road.
All right. Stockbridge,
Georgia.
All right. Mm-hmm. What about social media? Go ahead and shout that out.
Can find us at Pinstrikes Entertainment Center on YouTube.
Okay.
Pinstrikes 9 on Instagram and Pinstrikes on Facebook.
Okay, yeah. Okay. So out there in College Park. I'm trying to hear about, like, what school you went to, you know what I'm saying, and as far as, you know, neighborhood you grew up, you know what I'm saying, because there's a lot of people out there that's trying to figure out, because you talking about you from College Park when we all know you from Rockdale County. So I'm trying to figure out what part of College Park you from. Don't let us know.
Right down Creel Road, you know, I grew up in, I grew up on Old National when it was still middle class, you know, not trapped out like it is now, you know what I'm saying, very upper middle class neighborhood for blacks at the time. So right there on Creel Road, you know, everybody from Ludacris, 2 Chainz, a lot of history.
Ooh.
On Old National. Way back when there was the 20 Grand Club. Okay. And Triple J's Barbershop.
Okay.
So yeah, I've been around for a long time.
All right. Hey, stop, bro. He was about to jump on you, bro.
Oh,
I see seen him, bro. I know when my partner about to do something, bro. So I stopped him from getting on you, bro. So you really need to be thanking me for that, bro. Hey, chill out, bro.
Okay, I appreciate it, man.
Chill out, bro. We got guests on the show, bro. You just sat there and tried to jump on that man. I don't respect folks jumping nobody, bro. Chill out, bro. And then you got the pinstripe shirt on, though. But you got the pinstripe shirt on. Chill out, bro. Yeah. I got him up off you, bro.
Okay, I appreciate that.
I got
man.
Him up off you, bro.
Yeah, man, just calm down, bro.
I heard you smoke. Lift. Oh, hold on, bro. Whoa. Yeah, I got a blunt for him. That man gonna try to tell me he don't smoke. Yeah, right. Anyways, so you came from, you know what I'm saying, all these things, you went through all these things, so I heard you was in the Army, I heard you were stationed in Korea, El Paso, you know, tell us a little bit about that, man. I want to hear about that, because you probably was out there doing all kind of stuff that you weren't supposed to do, because you sure wasn't at the gym training your clients, because you still owe me that $50. But go ahead and tell us about Korea. Go ahead.
Okay, well, you know,
Lift. Lift weights for that. It's taking a little bit too long to tell us about Korea.
Okay. I don't
know. Yeah. Get it cracking.
Okay. So, yeah. You know, I didn't want to join the Army, but, you know, once I graduated, I kept coming home to, like, brochures and pamphlets for the Army on my bed. So I thought my mom was trying to tell me something. And then when she dropped me off at the recruiting office, she pretty much said, hey, listen, you need to do something. So I got a job at the Army, stationed in Korea, beautiful country, absolutely loved it. And as soon as I went from Korea, they sent me to another third world country, El Paso, Texas, which is no different than Mexico.
Okay.
Yeah. I might be the only black person that I see for weeks at a time. But it was a beautiful city. I had a good time, and I really enjoyed being in the Army.
Okay, okay, mm-hmm. okay. Well, you need to lift then, Mr. Armstrong. Since you enjoy being in there so bad. Was it perfect like your fro?
Yeah,
because it looked like you were taking too much time sitting there patting. You need to be worried about coming to the gym to train your clients for that $50 that you owe me, bro. I'm glad I got you here on the show now. Okay. You can't go nowhere. You owe me $50, bro. I want it today. Bro, I'm not giving you none of that, bro. You're not getting 25, bro. Talking about he finna get half.
I can't do a payment plan.
Talking about he finna get half, bro. Okay. Boy, stop. And you already know you better not say nothing, bro. Because I still give you your $5 allowance, bro. And you be spending it on all kind of stuff, bro. All kind of stuff, bro. So chill out, bro. Anyways, bro. This man don't even... Y'all don't even know. I was supposed to be the first Tybo. We was investing in Tybo videos, and this man gonna sit there staring me up to go to Korea. Yeah. I got something personal against him. Anyways, Mr. Club Promoter, I heard you used to promote. Tell me about the first gig you had promoting. I want to hear about this because I heard a lot about it. I want to hear about it. And I heard you drink. Go ahead and lift the bill up. Since you drank so much. And then I want you to tell me about your first event.
Well, the very first after party I did after I got out of the Army, I had got a deal with Clear Channel, which was Power 102 at the time.
Okay.
And they were throwing like a summer jam, you know, which they threw every year. And since it was El Paso, there was really no hip-hop club or place for them to do after parties. So I went to the thanks to my homeboy, DJ Black. He took me to the radio station, made it so I was able to get the advertising rights for the after party. So they gave me some backstage passes where I could basically just go behind the stage and ask the artist, hey, we're doing an after party after the concert. Would you like to come through?
Okay.
So basically... I'm getting advertising for my event, and I'm getting opportunities to ask the artists to come to my venue. Yeah, so, of course, they're going to come because they don't have any other place to go. Mm-hmm. So the very first one was with Genuine and Key Sweat.
Yeah. Okay.
Turned out absolutely amazing. Wow. I think I spent the whole time getting women for Genuine. Yeah, like, I mean, he probably knocked down 10 of them that night.
Okay.
In the kitchen.
You weren't there, bro. You weren't there.
Yeah.
You was not there. Bro, say he was there that night. There.
He looked familiar.
He looked familiar. Why that boy don't look familiar? Why don't
I remember it was like an orange dude there.
He sitting here flexing the jump on you, but he got the pinstripe shirt on, bro.
I don't know what
he
got.
Trying to act like he slick represent. But anyway, bro, go ahead, bro. You know what I'm saying? Tell me about that night, man, with Genuine and them. You know what I'm saying? Because you weren't so genuine when you came up talking about you weren't sweating to go get my $50 you owe me. Talking about you seeing Keith Sweat and Genuine, but you weren't genuine when you came up talking about you telling me the truth about going to Sweat to get my $50. The same $50 that you spent on the products to get that afro so perfect. But go ahead and tell me about this event with Genuine and Keith Sweat.
Well, I mean, that was just my first one.
Well, tell me about Lil Mo. I heard about a couple of big ones with guys like Eminem, Tyrese, JT Money, what I'm saying? Let me hear about that one, because I know that one turned up. I heard it was like some crazy stuff went on, too.
That one was kind of, I'm still kind of getting into the whole event planning as far as, like, having them food, their riders and everything that they want. So this particular after party, we had an opportunity to ask Eminem, who was on the ticket. It was Tyrese, Destiny's Child, and JT Money. He had that song, Who That, at the time. So it was real big at the time.
Okay.
So I remember we had a little buffet for him, some wings, some tenders, a couple of little snacks.
Right.
So I picked up Eminem and his crew, and I didn't realize he had that many people with him.
Yeah.
So, they went over there to the little buffet table, basically cleared it out.
Mm-hmm.
So by the time JT Money people got there, they were hungry. They would say, hey, we heard you guys had food for us at the after party. And I was just like, yeah, man, well, not anymore. The food that we had is gone. Eminem people kind of got to it first.
They smashed up all the food.
It was
the
gone.
The boy came in with the munchies.
Wasn't even a celery stick when they get done. So JT Money, it wasn't JT Money. It was his homeboy.
Yeah.
Make sure I get that straight. It was his homeboy
that
was... He didn't take it good. When I told him, I said, yeah, man, we ain't got no more wings. We out of food. He was just like, what do you mean we ain't got no more food? I was like, well, it was just kind of first come, first serve. Eminem's people got to it first. So I just saw his face contort, looking pissed off, and he went straight to Eminem, got in Eminem's face, and was just like, hey, why'd you eat up all the food? And Eminem, I'll never forget it, he stood there unfazed. He just stood there stone-faced, just staring at the dude. And, I think the dude realized when what he was doing wasn't working, he kind of calmed down. And at that point, Eminem security stepped in, got in between them. And dude was so big, it wasn't going to be no beef. I mean, he was, to this day, the biggest bodyguard I've ever seen.
So, they want no smoke.
Yeah, it was one of Dr. Dre's bodyguards. No, they didn't want none of that.
Okay. Hey, stop, bro. Stop, bro. Come on, bro. Let my body go, bro. Chill out, bro. You just gonna jump on that man while he trying to explain about JT Mill. You just gonna sit there and jump while he trying to explain about Eminem Mill, bro. We're not worried about that, bro. You keep trying to sneak up on that man, bro. You need to be a man and call that man out for the head of fame, and that's what you gonna do, bro. Chill out, bro. Chill out, bro.
Anyways, bro. See, they probably was trying to jump and get to fighting because you owed them $50 because you was supposed to go and they trained your clients and you probably owed them $50. That's why they was in there fighting. And you done sat there and spent all that money on what? What you spent all that money on? What's perfect?
So it's like an interview.
No, what's perfect, bro?
I don't. What we talking about?
What's perfect, bro?
I don't know.
What you spent the money on, bro?
You
ain't spending on no weed, bro. What you spending on that's perfect that I've been saying is perfect, bro?
Oh, man, some activator?
Yes! Your afro! You can call it activator, afro sheen, Murray's, whatever. You've been spending it. Where's my $50? Because you don't sit here and admit you've been spending it on Murray's and activator. That's why my partner jumped on you, bro. See, I keep trying to stop him from getting you, bro. I'm about to let him go do his thing in a minute, bro. No. You playing, bro. Anyways, bro. Yeah. So I heard you moved to Memphis.
Right.
I want to hear about Memphis, man. You know, Memphis on top with a lot of things right now. So, you know what I'm saying? I just want to hear about your experiences in Memphis, why you moved to Memphis. You know what I'm saying? Probably trying to get away from me and my $50. But anyways, I want to hear why you moved to Memphis, bro. Let me hear that, bro. Because there's a lot of things probably going on around that time. You was promoting and things like that. So, I want to see what's going on with the Memphis thing.
Well, instead of just waiting for the concerts to come during the summer, mm-hmm. I was like, let me see if I can get some artists to come down here. Because, you know, El Paso was just kind of just starting to kind of really get into hip hop. There was only one hip hop club. So I went over there because I had family out there. You know, went to the strip club, met a stripper, and she introduced me to Kingpin Skinny Pimp.
Okay.
You know, the legendary King of Memphis.
Okay.
And it was pretty much on from there because the relationship that I built with Kingpin Skinny Pimp allowed me to meet other artists.
Okay.
Project Players, Criminal Man, DJ Squeaky, Lil Chat, you know, so it really kind of gave me an opportunity to speak with those artists and try to get them down there to do shows.
That's fire. That's fire. I bet you paid them Kingpins they $50. You gonna sit there and stand me up my little 50. I bet you ain't no Kingpin, Skinny Pimp them gotta call you about their money. But you gonna do your boy like that. And that's why you gonna live. For things of that nature. For doing stuff like that. Yeah. But anyways, bro, now we on to Pinstrikes.
Right.
All right. So when did you start working there? What made you want to go ahead and grab your job up there, man? What was it? And what do you do up there?
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Tell me a little bit about you.
First, let me shout out my homeboy's movie.
Okay.
Criminal Man. He has just released a movie on Tubi called Neighborhood Dope Man. It's doing really well. And I really want y'all to go over there and check it out.
Check that thing out.
Neighborhood Dope Man, Criminal Man.
Okay.
He's doing
okay.
Big things. You'll be seeing a lot of movies from him and his production company here in the future.
Bet. Now, he just shouted that man out like that. But remember I told y'all I was supposed to be the first time, Bo? He was supposed to come be the head of my production. But he ain't want to come out there. And now he going to shout somebody else out. Now, props to that man. Go check that man's stuff out. But I'm talking about me and him. You know what I'm saying? Me and him. We're supposed to be doing Tybo videos together, bro. We're supposed to be like this. We're supposed to be like this, bro. And that man gonna do me like that. Anyway, man, when you started at Pinstrike, man, because I'm feeling some type of way, bro. So don't tell me about Pinstrike, bro. I'm putting all these things together, just time frames, and when he was supposed to be helping me out. So we're going to go ahead and get back to this, though. I really want to know about Pinstrike. Go ahead, bro.
I had never been in a bowling alley before I stepped in.
Okay.
So when I walked in, I was shocked. I was like, what is all these black people doing in a bowling alley? You know, because I'm used to Al Bundy, you know, the funny shirts, the teams, and it was nothing like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what made me really want to start working there was the fact that families were there and they were having a good time. And that's when I knew that that's something I wanted to be a part of. So, you know, I got on board as just a regular manager. They had a marketing director position come open.
Okay.
I applied for that, you know, got it.
Yeah. And you were already good at the promoting and stuff like
yeah,
that.
Yeah. So, you know, it was already knew how to, you know, edit commercials and do marketing campaigns and things like that. I just, you know, never went to school for it. I just kind of taught myself. But, you know, we have something for everybody. You know, we have a roller coaster. Not a real roller coaster. Okay. The first thing people do is they'll come in there and start looking around. It's a motion simulator.
Okay.
12 different roller coasters to choose from. 8 people can go at one time. So it's a platform with a wraparound screen. So you get the same feeling you would get from a real roller coaster. It's just a simulation.
Fire.
Then
Fire.
We have over 150 arcade games. You know, we have virtual reality, a 4-player virtual reality arcade. We had a rock wall. We don't have that no more. Due to some insurance issues, I guess another company had an accident on one of their rock wall where the kid fell from the top, broke both legs.
Ooh.
Now, any company that has a rock wall, their insurance went up by like $15,000 a month. Yeah. So we don't allow customers to use that anymore.
It's there, but
you just can't use it.
Yeah, because I thought
it's just for show. Decoration.
Okay.
Then we also have laser tag.
Okay.
and bumper cars.
Bumper cars. Bumper cars. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Full
okay.
restaurant, full bar. So, like I said, it's something for everybody. You know, got the bar and the restaurant for the adults. Got the arcade for the kids. So you can't go wrong when you bring your family out.
So you be trying to get folks lit at the bar. So they can forget about their $50 that you owe for training their clients. You gonna sit there and owe somebody $50 talking about adults at the bar, get them lit. I'ma owe everybody $50 for the night over. Nah, it don't work like that. If I collect a whole bunch of 50s, I get a whole bunch of money for hair products with my afro. No, it ain't gonna work like that. I'm not gonna let you get my money like that no more. You don't pay me my 50 for the show over with. Anyways, so you got all these laser tag, all these, you know, different things and different things you got going on. So what about this wall, this video wall I hear about? I hear it's like a wall, you know, in the back of the where they bowl at, you know, where you can see all the videos and everything like that. Let me hear about that.
Well, I would really appreciate it if you guys could kind of clip that in, you know. It's normally called a backdrop. You know, where you roll the balls go into the pins, and then there's a wall behind it. So basically now that's just one huge screen. That we can play different videos on, different effects.
I seen it the other night. It was hard.
3D wall mapping. So, like I said, we can customize a wall if you have like a corporate event with your logo, or, you know, if you have some special effects that you want to put up there. You know, we can do a lot with that wall. Advertising, you know, anything.
Okay. So you can just come in and, you know, just ask, you know what I'm saying, hey, I got an event going on. I want y'all to flash it across, you know what I'm saying, that big video wall you got right there. Like, what do y'all call it? You know what I'm saying? What do y'all call that wall?
It's just a video wall.
Okay.
And last time we used it, we had Teddy Riley. He hosted a celebrity bowling tournament.
I heard about some events y'all do up there and things of that nature. So you know, like, tell me about those, you know, campaigns, you know, things that y'all do up there. You know what I'm saying? Banquets. Stuff like that. You know. So like, I mean, you know, tell me a little bit about some of the banquets or some of the things that you've had up there, some of the events, the people that you that come up there, you know what I'm saying, things of that nature.
Well, this past May, we had about 200 to 300 kids every day. May is really big for field trips. That's usually the last month that schools do field trips because school is about to be out. So kids absolutely love it. We try to make it so that when the kids come there, they have an unforgettable experience. And they want to come back. Field trips are really major. We do a lot of family reunions. Major family reunions. The building can hold up to 1,000 people. We do a lot of sports banquets for schools, rec centers, stuff like that. We do sponsor some teams, so if you need some shoes, shirts, trophies, you can see us and we'll help sponsor your team. A lot of retirement parties. Georgia Power, they have a lot of retirement parties there. Mm-hmm. Teachers have a lot of retirement parties there. A lot of fundraisers. Where, you know, you'll rent out the building and then just charge a flat rate at the door. So, you know, we try to help nonprofit and different organizations make money.
All kind of stuff going on up there. See, I ain't even know all that. But see, the thing about him is he got a problem with communicating. That's why I ain't got my 50. That's why I ain't Tybo. And that's why his afro so perfect. Live. Yeah, but anyways, let's sit there and let this man know all that, interview this man and everything, since he all about the family, arcade games, you know what I'm saying, family shows and things of that nature. This next segment, we gonna see what we really got, what he really know, and what we really about. He gonna do a little something with me. We gonna see who better at it. All right. We about to get it now. Yeah. I got something for him today. Yeah. So, since he so in the family and, you know, family fun, and, you know what I'm saying, we doing stuff for Pinstrikes, and we just going hard. First of all, he going to lift my monkey, homie.
After that, we gonna go ahead and go into this. I'm gonna play a couple family songs. Our songs that's considered to be family songs. I'm gonna dance. I'm gonna do my thing. He gonna dance. He gonna do his thing. And then we gonna get them production to go ahead and judge and see who did the best. So go ahead, stand up. Let's get it cracking.
Yeah. We about to do this.
Oh, we're gonna get off the stage. Okay.
Yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and kick it off.
Okay, go ahead, man.
I'm gonna go ahead and kick it off. And y'all better say I did the best, bro. Y'all sitting down here, y'all better act like y'all know who really doing the best out here. So we're gonna go ahead and get it cracking. Here you go. This the first song.
Okay.
Let's see what you got. All
right.
We're gonna see what I got first. All right. And then we're gonna see what you got.
All right, let's go. All
right. Hey!
Boy, you sweat like hell, ain't you?
What's going on, man? We gonna go ahead and go back. We gotta sabotage it. Oh, we gotta sabotage it. Here we go. All right, I'm gonna give you something in the middle.
Okay.
Good morning, USA. I got a feeling that it's gonna be a wonderful day.
Just turn.
The sky has a smile on his face, and he's shining a salute to the American race.
Nah.
Oh boy, it's well to say.
Good morning, USA.
Yeah. Who won? Who won? Who won that one?
Okay, like you.
Who won?
I think this is like a B.O.B.
Biggz won? Yeah! It was me, Mr. Perfect Pro. I won that one. Yeah, we gonna play another one, Mr. Family. Mr. Family Songs. We gonna play another one.
Fantasia or something?
Nah, we gonna play this. Cause I'ma show them today.
Oh my God.
I'ma show them today.
Hey, no, stop, no, 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 no
I'm gonna have to step my game up.
I see my partner gonna have to come out here with me. Cause I need some lawyers. Anyways, we're gonna go to the next song.
Alright,
but you playing.
Gotcha.
You playing.
Excuse me.
Here we go. We got new ones.
Okay, cool.
It seems today that all you see is violence and movies and sex on TV.
Who won?
You put this together last night?
It was me.
So we got a tiebreaker. We got one more. You gotta come with your A game now. You gotta come with your A game now.
Alright, let me dig.
You gotta come with your A game now. Yeah. Come here, bro. Come on, bro. Y'all break that up, bro.
Stop, bro. Stop. Put your beater back on, bro. Stop.
You should do like a self-defense show.
Stop.
I think you got it, man.
Stop.
Don't let go of his neck.
I got him.
He's
up off
the neck.
I got him.
There you go.
All right, bro. Anyway, bro. We got one more, bro. All right, here we go, bro.
You okay, man?
Yeah. We got one more. All right, what we got next?
Now the world don't know you, you got me just one drum. What a plenty right for you.
Yeah. Now we're gonna go back. Okay. We're gonna go back. I press
now
the button.
The world don't know you, you got me just one drum.
It's your turn.
May not be right for some.
Who won?
This calls it a tie.
No.
Because it was equally ridiculous.
No, it's the break. Who won? Who won?
A tie. Yeah, man, you know what I'm saying?
Man, we're going to play one more. This gonna be the breaker right here.
Shit.
Only reason they gave you a little bit is because you got an afro just like your folks on the show. Here we go. We got another one for you. One, and I'm the one doing my thing. This man really thought he was gonna come here, and I was gonna forget about my $50. So this man is gonna come to the gym. I'm not gonna let him leave again. He gonna pay me my $50 today. Let's get on out of here now.